Now on fifth way two, Bill, the pilot's seat, driver's seat, is up forward of the engine. I'd like to have you explain for our friends in Portland and in Seattle and in Spokane, what is your feeling when you're out there on the front, as you explained to me yesterday?
Tommy, that's a real difficult thing to answer. It's hard to explain it because I've been driving for 14 years the other way. But it's just like being completely engulfed in a fog. You haven't any sensation of speed, with the exception of the wind. You can't hear the engine or anything like that. All you're getting is instrument readings, and you know what your engine's doing, but you can't hear it. And you don't realize that you use sound to drive with so much until you're deprived of it. And so as a result, I just about have to learn to drive all over again, all new, because it's an entirely new concept. It's so completely removed from what we've been doing that this new boat is going to be so revolutionary that naturally, if it's a lot faster than Miss Riftway, I'm interested in driving it. But right at the moment, we have a lot of work to do on it. It's a brand new concept, and I honestly believe that in time, it will revolutionize the sport from the standpoint of speeds. We'll be going 30, 40 mile an hour faster.
Bill, you won't be driving Thriftway 2 today. Can you tell us why?
Well, we cracked the only propeller we have available for Thriftway 2. We're just worried about, I don't know whether you remember, Tom, sure you do, though, in Lake Mead last year in the Miss Thriftway, we lost a propeller and the boat darn near sunk and tore everything up. Well, we cracked the only propeller we have available for Thriftway 2, and we're just afraid if we gamble on it, we could lose the boat, and this lake is very deep. So we'd rather make sure it's, we're happy with its performance, so real happy, because it's really a flying machine. And we'll get it ready for the Gold Cup for sure.
We're getting set for heat 1C. Hawaii Kai, Short Circuit, Maverick, Thriftway 2, and US 1. As Thriftway 2 goes out, Gale 6 is towed back in. The Thriftway 2 is a boat with a cab over design. The driver sits out in front. And brother, it's a real thrill. Brian Weigel is the driver, he's a jet pilot. They all begin to come around now to the top part. Miss U.S. is in between boats coming around the top part of the north corner. The Thriftway 2 is moving over here to the wide side, coming over to near shore lane. Miss U.S. is following her, and Hawaii Kai is coming off the top part of the north turn, coming down past buoy number 4, shaping around out there. As we have a total of 15 seconds to go, they begin to shape around in there. Hawaii Kai is on the inside corner, and Thriftway 2 is on the outside with Miss U.S. 4 in between the two boats. Now they're dead even, and it is Brian Weigel on the outside. It is Hawaii Kai on the inside. It is Miss U.S., and here comes the Thriftway 2 real hard down there as he gets over the mountain. And we're not just checking to see whether or not it was a false start. Thriftway 2 was across the line. The brother was real close. Hawaii Kai on the inside corner, and Miss U.S. was third, and the rest of the field swing out of there as Fascination was fourth in the outside corner. Going into the south turn now, we have no way of checking out whether or not that was a false start, but we'll have to check with one of the officials. Moving into the south turn on the first time around the course. It is Thriftway 2 running in first place. Hawaii Kai is running in second place. And running in third place is Miss U.S. 4 as the Bardol gets started being hung on the crane. Wow, boy. Everybody now coming out of the south corner. We have the Thriftway 2 out in front. And on the outside corner, the Thriftway 2 moving in real hard. And it is Hawaii Kai running in second place as the Thriftway 2 moves real hard. And Hawaii Kai comes up on her. And it's a two-boat race out there. In third place is running out of the south corner is Miss U.S. And back and forth place is Fascination. It is halfway up the back stretch now for your lead boat, Thriftway 2, followed by Hawaii Kai. This is the first of five times around the course. In third place in this U.S. 2. Swing out back to backstretch. Approaching the three-quarter mile of the backstretch. It is Thriftway 2 moving in on the first buoy of the north turn. And here comes Hawaii Kai coming up real hard now on Thriftway 2. Coming into the outside. Now moving to the inside corner. Less than two buoy markers between the two boats. It is Thriftway 2 running on the top part of the turn. Running down now, and Hawaii Kai comes out real hard on the outside. Trying to come up on the inside, but Brian Weigel maintains position. And we have Hawaii Kai going in through a rooster tail, coming on real hard. It is Thriftway 2. Past the 1,000-foot mark, there goes Hawaii Kai past the 1,000-foot mark. And Jack Regis goes out after it real hard. Here comes Thriftway 2 at the end of lap number 1. Out of touch by a second and a half over Hawaii Kai. They start lap number 2. Coming out of the north turn, it's a third place boat, Miss U.S. 4, followed by Fascination. Going down to the south corner and a second time around the course. We have no report as yet as to whether it was a fair start. It was a fair start, evidently, from what they tell us. So it is Thriftway 2 running out in front. Closely followed by Hawaii Kai, as Hawaii Kai is less than 1 second behind. It's a terrific two-boat duel as they go into the south corner and a second time around. It is Thriftway 2 out in front. Hawaii Kai is running in second. And there is less than 1 second between the two boats. Brother, they're wrestling neck and neck. In third place is U.S. 4, and in fourth place is Fascination. This is the second time around the course. Hawaii Kai, Jack Regis coming on real hard, trying real hard to make it a clean sweep out here to win this third heat. As he comes on Thriftway 2, a boat that he fairly feared all the time. 97 miles an hour for Thriftway 2. And in fourth place with his Fascination 30 seconds behind. All right, here we go, up the backstretch. It is Hawaii Kai coming up real hard now. And Thriftway 2 begins to move away from Hawaii Kai in the straightaway on the backstretch. It is Thriftway 2 finding herself out here in this third and final heat in the dark as the Hawaii Kai begins to pitch and roll out there and loses distance to a boat that is really moving hard and moving through this trap out here in real easy fashion. The cab over design of Thriftway 2. And Ted Jones finally sees his boat after all season long. Comes through here with a well-known thing called Crab. And Hawaii Kai comes on too. She's a champion not to be denied. In third place, well back. About halfway up the back stretch is Miss U.S. 4 with Donnie Wilson at the wheel and Fascination rounds out of the south corner. This is the second time around the course. Approaching the 1,000-foot mark. In first place, less than a second behind, is Thriftway 2 out in front now by a second over Hawaii Kai. Here comes the Thriftway 2, 500 feet away from the finish. Kai is at the 1,000-foot mark, 200 feet away, over the line, into lap number 2. And here comes Hawaii Kai, running in second place. Kai is now 2 seconds behind. And Hawaii Kai, with Jack Regis at the wheel, goes hard after the lead boat to strike two, driven by Brian Weigel. Weigel was into the south corner now in his third time around. As the third place boat comes out of the north corner, that is Miss US-4, and Fascination just approaches the back stretch. Now we go real hard in the south corner on the lead boat. The lead boat is Swift Break 2. This is the third time around the court, the third and final heat. And running hard in second place is the wide car. Less than 2 seconds between the two boats. 96 miles an hour for Swift Break 2 in the second time around the third corner. The wide car back now, about a second and a half, 2 seconds behind. As Brian Weigel comes on, it's virtually dead dark out here. These two boats taking a tremendous duel. Third and fourth place boats coming out of the south corner. This is the third time around. Hawaii Kai coming to the inside corner. Can't quite make it. As Brian Weigel goes in on the inside corner. And Hawaii Kai comes down about two boat lengths behind him. Here's the end of lap number three. Swift Break 2 is leading. And in second place, about 1 second behind, is Hawaii Kai. 98 miles an hour for Swift Break 2. And Swift Break 2 begins to move now on the inner stretch approaching the south corner on her fourth time around. Hawaii Kai is trailing by about 2 seconds now as they approach the south corner. What a race! In third place approaching the north corner in her third time around the course is an issue as four, and Fascination is just coming out of the south corner. There could be a lapping. Swift Break 2, halfway through the south corner now on her fourth time around the course. About a 2 second lead over Hawaii Kai in this, the third heat of the Sahara Cup. A tremendous duel out here. Hawaii Kai tries to come to the inside corner. Now we start up the backstretch for the two boats. It is Hawaii Kai coming up real hard now and losing ground a little bit now, coming out of the exit buoy as Swift Break 2 pours on the seat. Swift Break 2 is coming halfway up the backstretch now, leading in first place, gaining on Hawaii Kai. Miss US-4 in third place. She is a minute behind the leader. And Miss Fascination is about a minute and a half behind. It is Swift Break 2 in her fourth time around the course, gaining a little bit on Hawaii Kai in his fourth time around the course. Ryan Weigel driving a big race out there. And Jack Rakes coming on real hard, trying to get to him. Coming on. And once again, we have the Swift Break 2 proving himself real hard. Swift Break 2, winner by less than 2 seconds over Hawaii Kai.
They're fairly even. Maverick is wide. Swift Break 2 is just slightly out in front. And it's pretty all on the inside. It was Swift Break 2, Maverick. And on the inside corner, they're dead even going down into that corner. It's Swift Break 2 moving over to the inside now. And Maverick coming in from the outside. It's a two-boat duel going into that race. Boy, they're really bunched on this one. They're just now going through the bottom part of the turn. Somebody has to give. Swift Break 2 is in there real hard now. About a half boat length out in front. It looks like Maverick is in second place. And the rest of the field is going up. Freddie Alder in Miss U.S. is in third place. And the Miss Spokane coming up hard in fourth place. And in fifth place is Miss Pay and Save. Now, coming out of the exit buoy, it is Swift Break 2 out in front. And here comes the Maverick hard on the outside corner. Halfway up that backstretch now. Stead looks like he's dropped out and away. As Swift Break 2 takes over and Freddie Alder moves into second place. And Maverick drops off to third place.
Oh, Stead's still in it.
Stead is still in it now. He's on the outside. Swift Break 2 now approaching the west turn for the first time around the course. Maverick buried in the spray on the outside, came out of it very nice now. And she's coming up real hard on Swift Break 2. Maverick going to the outside now as Brian Weigel has to swing wide. And here comes Maverick, the defending champion. Bill Stead really pouring the heat to her. And it is, looks like another boat duel, like between Hawaii Kai and Swift Break 2 down at Lake Mead. Here we are, dead even, coming down the line now. As Swift Break 2 pours down the cold. And the last one coming up. Maverick, you're dead even at the end of lap lap one. In third place is Freddie Alder in this U.S. class. In fourth place is Mitch Locan. In fifth place is Pan Save. 107 miles an hour for the first time around the course. We're going down to the east turn now, and both boats are dead even. Slipway 2 on the inside corner, and Maverick on the outside corner. And Freddie Alder in third place, about 10 seconds behind. The fifth place boat is just 12 seconds behind the leader. Slipway 2 is out in front now, and Maverick is on the outside, having to give ground to that outside position. Here's your race for first and second and third and fourth as they move through the bottom part of the east turn. On that third and fourth position, Freddie Alder in third place, and Dallas starts moving, and here we are, dead even, going up that back stretch now as Slipway 2 on the inside corner, and Maverick makes her bid right now. Bill Stead goes hard. Here they are, dead even. Watch them. Slipway 2 takes over once again. Three-quarters of the way up the back stretch. Slipway 2 moves into that corner for the second time around the course. And the terrific move in third and fourth place as Miss U.S. 1. And Freddie Alder. And back of him is Dallas Starts in Miss Spokane. Coming up hard now on Freddie. And in fifth place is Pan Save. Now rounding out of the west turn on his second time around the course is the boat of Slipway 2 driven by Brian Weigel. And it is Maverick trying to take over on the inside corner and almost making it. He's coming down now, trying to get on the inside corner. Maverick coming up the inside. Boat is buried in the spray inside. You can't see it. He's inside. And Freddie Alder. There's your boat. Slipway 2 moving into the east corner on their third time around. And it is Maverick on the inside now. Man, they're really tight in there.
Oh, he went through.
And he shut him out. He went through, and I think looks like he's dying down. Yes, sir. Maverick went through the rooster tail, and he'll have to pick up ground now. In fifth place is Pan Say. We're in the third lap. And Slipway 2 is coming off the exit buoy now. And Maverick comes hard after her now. As Slipway 2 seems to labor a little bit, coming off the exit buoy. Maverick, with Bill Stead at the wheel, comes charging back. He crushed through the rooster tail. He almost drowned himself out. Well, Jack Ragus, what's the experience like to go through a rooster tail like that? Your third and fourth place boat now coming off the exit buoy. Your third place boat is Miss U.S. 1. Fourth place boat is Miss Spokane. Miss Pay and Save is in fifth place, 33 seconds behind. Miss Spokane is 18 seconds behind the leader. Maverick in first is 1 second behind. Now we go to the top of the turn here on the west side of the course. This is the third time around. 107 and 106 miles an hour for the first two times around the course for these 1-2 boats. Slipway 2 out in front now, approaching the end of a third lap, as he really cut off Maverick, trying to get down that inside corner once again. Bill is really nearly living dangerously. He tries to get to the inside corner once again, too, at the end of lap 3. Couple of miles. Lap 4. And Maverick dropped off in second place. Maverick is 2 seconds behind in second place at the end of lap 3. Your race for third and fourth is fairly tight, as Freddie Alder maintains his third place position, coming down at the end of lap number 3. Going into the west corner, east corner, we have the first and second place boats, 103 miles an hour for Slipway 2 at the end of 3 laps. Slipway 2 now is picking up distance on Maverick as the fourth place boat, Miss Spokane, just went over the line at the end of lap 3. And here comes the fifth place boat, Miss Pay and Save. And first, second, third, and fourth moving into the screen on our hillside camera. First place is Slipway 2, Maverick is in second. Third place is Freddie Alder. And in fourth place, we have Miss Spokane with Pan Save coming down to fifth place. Up the back stretch on her fourth time around the course goes your lead boat. It is Slipway 2. And Maverick comes after her now, having dropped off to about 3 seconds behind. And Freddie Alder has moved up in Miss U.S. 1 now and lengthened the lead over Miss Spokane running in fourth place. Moving into the west turn. On her fourth time around the course, Slipway 2, Brian Weigel at the wheel. And it is Maverick coming up on her about a buoy length and a half behind. And Freddie Alder in Miss U.S. 1 running in third place with Dallas Sarts, Miss Spokane running in fourth place. And in fifth place is Miss Pan Save running down the count here as we approach the end of lap number 4. The Slipway 2 is running out in front. She was 2 seconds out at the end of the third lap. Now let's see if she's picked up any distance. I know she has. At the 1,000-foot mark, 500 feet away, over the line, in the lap four. Here comes Maverick. Maverick winding up his second place in lap number four. He is now 9 seconds behind the leader. In third place, coming out the west turn in the fourth time around the course, is Miss US 1 with Freddie Alder at the wheel. Over the line, into lap number four for her. We're starting the fifth and final time around the course. Out of the west turn, on her fourth time around the course, is the fourth place boat, Miss Spokane, Dallas Sarks, at the wheel. The jet pilot doing very well for himself out there. 21 seconds behind in third place, Miss US 1. That was your fourth place boat. Now your fifth place boat is just rounding out of the west turn. 107, 106, and 103 miles an hour for your lead boat, Tripway 2, who's moving out of the exit buoy up the backside for the fifth and final time in 81 feet. Miss Payne is saved just off the line. She's 55 seconds behind the leader. Miss Spokane is 36 seconds behind the leader. Tripway 2 is three quarters of the way up the backstretch, and she has picked up even a little more time on second place boat, Maverick. Some talk about a boat hitting a buoy. We'll check out a little later for you. Tripway 2 moving into the top part of the... There's the buoy over. It's the exit buoy of the west turn. And it looks like somebody's hit it. It was supposedly Stead, but we'll say no more than that. Supposedly Stead. Tripway 2 coming down now to the inside corner as Maverick moves to wide of the corner, the exit buoy of the west turn. 1,000-foot mark for Tripway 2. 500 feet away, over the line. Winner of heat, unspeed. Tripway 2. And in second place is Maverick. 10 seconds behind the leader. Third place is Miss US 1. Over the line, Freddie Alder from Detroit. And he was 18 seconds behind the leader. The fourth place boat is coming out of the west turn now, and her fifth time around. Dallas Sarts in Miss Spokane. Boat looks beautiful. Kid did a real good job. Real tremendous. He'd be real proud of this boat and real proud of this driver. He held on, maintained himself real nicely. Fourth place finish for it. End of the race of Heat 1B for Miss Spokane. And your fifth place boat, Miss Pay and Save, coming out of the corner now with Al Benson at the wheel, coming down to the 1,000-foot mark. 10th place finish, Miss Pay and Save. Miss Spokane, 42 seconds behind the leader. Miss Pay and Save, 62 seconds behind the leader. This is the second annual Apple Cup race, coming to you live and direct from the shores of Lake Chelan at Chelan, Washington. Here on the official barge, we have been attempting to find out if the buoy was knocked down or watered over. And we've had two different reports. From the publicity director here at Lake Chelan, he says no report. And Harry Woods, who is not the official referee, incidentally, has been acting as referee during the week on the time trials. But in this particular case, Stan McDonald is the official referee. We'll prefer to call it no report. We'll let it go at that. That's what they told us. So, in lieu of that, we'll tell you. Here's the order of finish. Tripway 2 is the winner of Heat 1B. And she averaged, unofficially, 104 miles an hour. 103.8. Unofficially. Second place went to Maverick until such a time as decided she might have hit a buoy and have to be disqualified. Maverick wound up 10 seconds behind the leader in second place. Miss US 1 had third place, 18 seconds behind the leader. Fourth place went to Miss Spokane, 43 seconds behind, and Miss Payne saved 62 seconds behind in fifth place. Let's go down to the pits now, Tommy Dargan and Charles Herring.
I think it's wonderful. Oh, I'm so
excited. In case we were cut off in the microphone, that was Mrs. Brian Weigel, whose husband is now approaching the dock. And she's very happy, of course, as I'm sure Brian is, too, because this is his first time for a first place for him in Thriftway, too. And there's the applause, and Mrs. Weigel saying, attaboy. Well, the Thriftway camp is doing very, very well today. I wish you could have seen Bill Muncy down here shouting encouragement, instructions, and just a general kind of hysteria to Brian as He took the lead in Thriftway 2 and kept it. But so far here in this first heat, A and B, we have to say that the Thriftway camp has got the money, marbles, and chalk, and are certainly dominant out here so far this afternoon with the beautiful performance of these two boats, which are, of course, radically different in design, the Thriftway 2 being a 1 point and the Thriftway a 3 point. Brian, congratulations, boy. There's Mama. And a big kiss. Well, this is your first time. How does it feel, Brian?
Really? It feels real good, believe me. Tom, it's wonderful.
And the boat did everything you wanted it to do.
It's beautiful. We've got a boat, man.
We've got two boats. And Willard, of course, is smiling and very, very happy, too. Two magnificent boats. And now back to Bill O'Mara on the barge.
Coming down to the 1,000-foot mark, moving very hard. This boat has wonderful straightaway speed, but has had trouble in the corner. 500 feet away from the start of its qualifying. Over the line, lap one. Lap one for Thriftway 2. She goes to the south corner for the first of three times around the course. Thriftway 2's highlight in her particular career was last year when she dueled with Hawaii Kai through five furious laps. Here you see the toughest part of Thriftway 2 is her turning ability, whether or not she has a prop that can let her ride through that corner. She loses most of her time there. She has tremendous straightaway speed, and her acceleration sometimes coming off the corner is a little bit slower than the rest, but when she does get her speed up, because the driver is sitting up front, she has a great effort. Again, he is real slow coming up to the acceleration point. Now he's up there. He's about a quarter of the way up the course when he gets under full goal. He's approaching the halfway mark, and we'll put a clock on him at the top end of his speed up that straightaway. In the backstretch of the first of three times around the course, Thriftway 2. 175 miles an hour as he goes into that corner. Ryan Weigel having to come down in a hurry. If he could just get a little quicker acceleration out of the corner, he could drive that on a more even pattern. Up at the top part of the north turn now. This is the first of three times around the course. A qualifying effort for Thriftway 2. A wide swing for Ryan Weigel. He's going to come wide and try to hit that buoy going flat out. Again, he comes down, and he isn't coming down hard at all. Now he's coming back up again at the 1,000-foot mark. He gets her moving. 500 feet away. End of lap one, 100 miles an hour. 100 miles an hour for the first of three times around the course. Thriftway 2, attempting to become the sixth boat to qualify, has turned in unofficially a time of 100 miles an hour for the first time around the course. And he's still having a lot of trouble through those corners. You have to be able to go through in about 13 or 14 seconds if you're really going to save your engine up that back stretch. Ryan Weigel coming in on his fourth buoy now, the south corner. Moving up the back stretch. Now let's see if he can get the boat up and moving. Now he begins to move. This is his second time around the course. He'll be full up now at the halfway point. At the three-quarter point. Ooh!
Oh, geez. Right.
The boat took a bad slide to the right. And now the Coast Guard will have to hurry. And the boat is right side up. It looked like it snapped to the right, as though the sponsor might have given. We'll put our glasses on it. We don't see Brian. Let's see. He's up there. He's in all right. So there is great proof of the stability of that boat. She seemed to slide to the right and go off. The helicopter is hovering overhead. He lost it at the three-quarter point, and that's just exactly the same point on the course where Slow Motion 4 took her famous flip. What did I say? Slow-mo 5, I beg your pardon. Ryan Weigel, and may I mention right now that our coverage features the only videotape facilities of the Gold Cup and also these time trials, which means that we can give you a rerun on this exciting event and a fortunate one in the fact that Brian Weigel is not hurt. He is standing up on the boat, and what the damage is to the boat, we don't know. We'll have to wait until the Coast Guard gets us word. We'll be right back. plate boat is Swiftway 2, a quarter of the way up the backstretch. Now they've been pretty well spread out. This is the third time around the course. Swiftway 2, who had the problem of whether or not to put a prop on that would reduce her straightaway speed, but improve her cornering speed. Or to take a prop that would give her 5 to 10 miles an hour faster in the straightaway, but 3 to 4 seconds faster or slower in the turns. So she took that latter combination because it figured out mathematically that she would still make 5 miles an hour faster even losing it through the turn. And Brian Weigel is driving with the basic theory in mind that 105 miles an hour will win this race. Of course, Mr. Hawaii Kai with Jack Riggs at the wheel has turned 108 for the first 10 times around the course. Swiftway 2 hooking off the exit buoy, the left-hand turn, running out in front as the Burien, trying to make up on the field now, is coming up and has passed the Gale 6 and is moving on the lead boat, but she's a lap behind. Your first place boat going to the south corner at the end of the third lap. Running in second place is Gale 6. The Burien has now charged up through the entire field and is going in the lead boat to try to get back in the race. And Bill Brow is giving her quite a ride. Wild Root Charlie has slipped to fifth, and Burien is fourth.
Now we'll watch and see if he gives a wave. Earlier this morning, some boats were on the water. Miss Everett got out tooled around the course with her new engine and not running too rapidly. Coral Reef got out and just barely out of the pit area and had trouble starting once again. Coral Reef actually has not been started successfully yet, and Coral Reef is one of the boats that must qualify today. We noticed that the Colroy 2 is in the pits, another one that must qualify, and also the Miss Seattle. Miss Seattle was brought in without an engine, and one will be mounted in her, and she'll evidently make the qualifying attempt today. You're looking at Colonel Rush Schley in Thriftway 2, up the back stretch, and when he comes around again, they'll start timing him. The boat appears to have good straightaway speed, and it may be a matter of getting around the turns as to whether this is a real contender or not. This is a big boat. Thriftway 2, maybe the heaviest boat out there. I think the only boats that are any heavier are some of those older Detroit jobs that used to be out here and aren't running anymore. Okay, she's in the straightaway, and this is the time when she crosses the line, they'll start timing her for the qualification run. Here it comes. Thriftway 2 is a Ted Jones designed boat, but actually built by Les Stoddicker in 1956, and she weighs 8,500 pounds. Has a Rolls Merlin engine, and actually was designed so two engines might have been put into her, but two never have run the boat. It's always been run with one. Through the right turn he goes. This is the first lap. Colonel Rush Schley, the defending champion driver of the Seafarer Trophy race. Now he comes out of the turn, starts to get up that rooster tail and go hard on the back stretch. The Colonel has been a spectator at both the Apple Cup and Diamond Cup races, but he's back in the saddle again. And very good straightaway speed on the back chute today. Oops, and just as we say that, the boat cuts out. The engine cuts out, but he gets her going again. Decelerate for the left turn. It would appear that the boat will have no trouble qualifying for Sunday. And again, it's a question mark as to whether she will be a real contender in the race. Okay, the biggest of the monsters on the lake heads out of the turn and down the straightaway. Finally, the acceleration starts. Here she comes, and we'll have the time for you shortly. 1,000 feet from home. And she's across. 105+, unofficially, for the one qualification lap. Now, whether Colonel Russ will keep her going to try to get on the money board, we'll just have to wait and see. He indicated that he would do so if the boat were running properly and up to snuff, in his opinion. But unofficially, that first lap, which was the one for the qualification record, 105.058. He didn't appear to be pushing it after crossing the line and heading down the rest of the straightaway. He's now coming through the right turn. And we'll see if he really stomps on it coming up the back stretch, which may be an indication of whether he's going to continue the run for the three laps and money. So at least we have another boat in the race as of now. Thriftway 2 would make the 14th. And if there is one more boat to get in, that means we will have three sections of Heat 1 on Sunday.